Okay, we are live. We mentioned we might be able to get Kat and Bing on here. Surprise! Yay. We are here live from Faith and Freedom Coalition in Orlando, Florida. And this is one of those rare times where Kat is not actually speaking at the event, but she felt like God told her to be here. And so I'm just going to be quiet and let her talk. And we're especially, I will just say this first, we're so glad that you get an opportunity to meet Bing.
A strong man.
Yes. He is a gentle giant. This is a man who is a giant in the spirit. We've gotten to be around him a few times now, and just, we love you. Yes. And we love the team that y'all are. And so I told Bing, you need to be on here with us. So anyway, hi.
Hi.
We're so glad to have another opportunity to hang with you guys. And I know everybody just wants to hear what's the latest thing that God's been speaking to you, and especially about the nation, but anything else that he tells you to say.
Yes. These are just exciting days to be alive. He always has me say that. And every day I have more and more expectancy in me. And by the way, if you didn't know this, you can ask God to give you expectancy. Some people just think, well, I can pray for things I need, maybe things I want, or to help others. You can ask for a lot more from him. If you actually say God, sound wisdom, extreme discernment, I ask for and receive excitement and celebration. You know what? You're going to have it, even if that's not something that's normally going on in you. You need to be in that place, because we're going to see some of the greatest things ever happen on this earth. And we got to be, we were chosen. Our birth was timed on the earth to be here now, during these great days where we'll see the hand of God move in such powerful ways. Probably not since the Old Testament will some of these things will be happening. And your heart should be overjoyed that you're here. Because you'll have stories to tell your children, your grandchildren, your great-great-great-great-grandchildren, if you're still here. And so these will be days they sing about. That's what the Father says. They'll sing about these very days we're in now. And some people look around and say, these are the worst days we have. No, trust me, I've actually seen some of the tribulation periods. No, these are nothing. These are nothing. These are the devil's plans, so you can have a choice. These are the devil's plans, what's going on, and he's found enough wicked, evil people just to collude with him, and he is so happy. He's about to have some of the worst days he's ever seen in his life. Hell is trembling, and I can tell you, you can almost tell when hell is trembling, by the way, when they have to leak a few things out that they're not willing to say in the fake news in your, or on Facebook. They don't even call it Facebook anymore, he calls it Facebook. And you know, this is the thing. He actually has a heart for who's the one who owns Facebook?
Zuckerberg.
He has a heart for him. He said, I gave him the understanding. So this is someone who's just kind of turned in the wrong direction. I'm still praying for him to turn back to God.
Yeah.
Because God does have plans for people. He gives them witty ideas and inventions. And he gave him this whole Facebook thing so we would have a way to communicate. Well, having to go through the normal streams, you know, I'm the old school, you know, send it through the mail, maybe drive and visit somebody. But how awesome is the internet? And the Father also informs me it belongs to him. Well, and we've seen enough of the evil side, but you're about to see some glory coming through your screens.
Wow.
And I tell people, every phone, every laptop, every iPad, those are actually portals. There's portals that open every time we go on and say something. Everyone is listening in the unseen realm. So you have an audience you never dreamed of. I see that audience. So I get excited even when I'm here right now. There's so many here that people don't see. Yeah. And sometimes every now and then one of the living creatures will visit. Or I love when the seraphim show up, especially if there's powerful worship or the heart of people. If they're crying out to God to know him in the midst of all this, saying there's got to be more than this. I don't care what's going on in my normal life. I am seated in eternity with Christ. And when the heart cries out, did you know that you draw the very seraphim from the throne room of God where they worship day and night? And they have blue fire. Their hair turns into blue fire. So I see portals open in the ceiling. Here they come dipping down in over the people, sometimes over the speakers. Sometimes they may not even have a solid relationship with Christ, but it's going to change. When they come into the presence where these people are, they impart them with things just by going by. They'll impart stuff into them, and their heart will begin to grow with a desire they never had before to know what does God say? What is God thinking about all this? Surely he cares about us. Are you kidding? He cares. He's your father. He's all of our father. And I tell people all the time, we're all family. In heaven, everybody gets along. Nobody argues or fights. You know what? There's still a chance to not always agree. Now, I didn't say that wouldn't happen because big events going on all the time. And people, some people have a little bit better idea maybe to do it. Sometimes maybe even your family members are holding a big event in heaven. You know, a million people could come. Wow. Trust me, they have the property to do it. And so when people get together, they'll invite people, well, come help me plan this. And I know that you're really good. You did catering on years. Would you do catering for my event? And so there's things going on. Heaven has a, I can't say natural lifestyle. They have a fantastic lifestyle in heaven, but people don't change. They get better. They're not mean or nasty. Of course, they're not calling people names anymore. Even the grumpy ones are happy. But people sometimes still have what God put in them. And if they are like event planners, if they do catering on the earth, and that's their gift, they're going to still get to do that in heaven. And this is the thing, if you have a family member working with you that in that event, it may not be maybe the best thing you've done. Having been head of hospitality in a 4,000 member church, I understand. Ask anyone but your family, right? For all those who have to, I know sometimes that's who you have, just throw grace on them, okay? Just throw grace on them or ask them at least, can you please, I'll pay you to do this, but ask for grace before we get in here and start doing things. So heaven is totally connected to our lives on this earth. And we're a shadow. This earth is a shadow of heaven. It says so in the Bible. And so there's countries in heaven. It talks about the cities in heaven. It actually mentions it in the Word of God. It talks about, you know, when Christ said, I go to prepare a place for you. Did you know that place could have more than one mansion on it? So you need to stretch your understanding of, number one, who God is himself. He knew everything before it happened. He knows how everything's going to play out. He knows who has his heart and who does things for him. And maybe you've never seen or heard. He knows every time you smile at somebody. He knows every time you reached out to help people. So in this time, it's so important to love others, maybe even especially those who don't love us. Yeah. And I can tell you what happens when you do that. When you speak well of people, maybe they have a great gift. Maybe they're not even using it for God, but you know they're powerful in what they do. Just tell people that. Maybe mention that to them. I mean, they may not be on the right path right now, but they do great at what they do. You know, they're honorable. They have integrity. And this, you know what? That's going to be number one. Bless their angel who's with them all the time. Aww. So we need to sometimes consider the unseen around us. But there's more activity now than I have ever seen in all the years I've been doing this for like 20 years. More activity in the spirit realm now than ever before. And a lot of it's couriers bringing things, delivering things, God imparting things, putting new mantles on you. You know, he's positioning people who nobody knows anything about. And that, but God has plans for them. So get ready for some new faces, some powerful people who are about to step into the center ring. And in case you didn't know it, are we still going? The other one is still going.
Yeah.
We still have some more juice there.
Yeah.
Maybe you did not know this too all, but God is a show person. He's about to put the biggest show on yet so far. And so is the Son, His Holy Spirit. And he intends to use us. We get to be a part of the third show. The first one in heaven, the second one in hell, and now one on the earth. And we, as the body of Christ, the family of God, finally coming together and agreeing that we want freedom, liberty, and justice in this country and not just here. Right. We as America, we stand in the gap for the whole rest of the world as far as God is concerned. He called us to reach the nations. And every tongue, tribe, and nation is represented in heaven, no matter what your skin, your color is. You belong to God. You are all important to him. He loves all of us. And so I can just say, expect the veil of the spirit realm to get thinner and thinner. And one day we will all be seeing angels, probably our own first. Just turn around and say thank you, okay? That's going to be okay. I tell people, if one shows up in your room and you really find out he is from God, maybe he's your own angel. I've had people who would attend certain meetings where God gave great impartations for encounters, and they went home and sat on the sofa and they saw their angel sitting next to them. I've seen all kinds of things like that happen. Or they're sitting in the car, running alongside you in the car to make sure that you get where you're going. without any interference from Satan. There's so much to say, but I can just say, the Father, what is he right now? The most excited being in all existence, except for Holy Spirit.
Come on.
The drama king, that's what they call him. He is going to be so much involved in our lives. Oh my gosh, you know, baptism in fire, right? And the outpouring of the glory everywhere that we will carry it will be so great. These things haven't happened yet. I mean, what about the greater works, okay? We're still trying to do the works. The greater works, raising someone from the dead at the funeral. After they have been cremated, that's the greater work. Stopping an earthquake and telling it will be put back the way it was. The buildings come up, the people come back to life. Those are greater works. Well, those haven't happened. We can't go anywhere. He's not going to let you go anywhere. And he's about to get your family members. Trust me. All the prayers you have prayed for all these years for them to know him, love him, belong to Jesus Christ. You're going to start to see a lot of restorations happen. In the midst of all of this mess that Satan has created, he thinks he's won. He's always a loser, always will be a loser. But it's exciting to see other people finally coming together and sharing their passion, their heart for what God wants. America is free. And as the Father said, the devil made a big mistake trying to take a free country away from God when it belongs to God. And this is his land. He says to me all the time, my name are on your papers. My words are sung in your songs. And so if you think he cares about this country, he is passionate about America. He calls it his gift to the world.
Come on.
I know his son is a gift, but countries sometimes are gifts to this world. America is one of those gifts. They're not stealing God's gift away from him. You know, they're just going to get zap, bam, is what's going to happen to them. And I can promise you, as the Father continually tells me, Trump is the president right now of the United States of America. He won the election. He never lost.
Nope.
You know, God knows who stole it. He knows every person involved. He knows all the crime and the corruption, the evil, the wickedness. And I know human trafficking. He knows where everyone went, who took them, what they did to them. You'd be shocked at what is about to be exposed, the avalanche of fraud, hate, and injustice that has been operating in this country. But this is the thing. When God's going to do something, one of the greatest things he's ever done on the earth, he has to expose the evil so it can be dealt with, whether in the courts, out of the courts, whether in the courts of heaven, or by God himself. He's going to make sure this country is in position and in place to do the greatest things we've ever done. America will be far greater than it was before. And these are his words. People will come one day to America, not even for the American dream. They will come to find me.
Come on.
So that is the word I have to say.
That is
so and good. I'm so glad I got to share with everybody. Stay excited. Remember to ask for that excitement, the expectancy and celebration, because you're calling those things to be not as though they were. It's not like we're crazy, except maybe crazy for Christ.
Yes.
So don't let anything stop you from pursuing what God gave you to do. He still plans to do it. I know people have been waiting 40 years. Don't step back, but stay where you are and begin to celebrate who he is first. And then you desire that his plans be done, his will, his way. In this country, he's going to do it anyway. Why not be a part of his plan?
And Kat, so good. We heard just a little while ago that a reporter from The Guardian They interviewed you, not really knowing who you were. But
that's right.
You had fun with
them. They were bushwhacked by God. Because I have learned a very long time ago that God has his own timing, and we have our plans. It's important to make plans. But sometimes God has his own. So I was right on time walking down the main hallway towards the Lafayette room. And this man says, may I interview you, please? He had a British accent. He said, I'm from The Guardian. I didn't even know who they were. And God said, you're going to say something for me? So he got both barrels. I can tell you that. Because he said, well, who are you? I said, well, I'm a prophet of God. He said, oh, do you call yourself that? I went, no, God himself calls me that. And I said,
I'm sure he was
and
like,
I said,
what?
I will say this about this event. It's very powerful that people are coming together. They still have hope for justice and liberty to happen. He said, well, what do you know about that? I said, I will tell you all the way back from November the 3rd that God the Father told me when they shut down the voting and said, we're going to take a break, the father said to me, this is when they lie, cheat, and steal. They're going to change the votes, burn the votes, bury all the ballots. And he said, and then they're going to use the system to put in hundreds of thousands of lying, false ballots. And he said, and what system was that? I said, it was called the Dominion system. I said, but it isn't going to work. And 80 million of us know Trump is our president right now. We know he won in 2020. That's his rightful title. He said, well, what do you think about Biden? I said, I think he's a liar and a villain. And by the way, that's what God thinks about him, too. And this man was so
writing notes as fast as he could.
At first, he was making a little scribble or two. Then when I said that, he goes, he starts writing every word that God had me say about the left and about the liberals and all the stuff that's been going on. And I said, don't you know that when you build a foundation on evil, it will never stand, because nobody cares about one another. There's no solid foundation. Nobody cares. There's no way to hold it together. It's already crumbling. I tell you what I think. I think the left is very terrified of who we are as a body of Christ. Even God himself, they deny him, but they know inside themselves there is one. And so I just informed him in case he had forgotten that God was still in control. And when he was done exposing all the wickedness and evil that had gone on, everybody would be brought to justice and God would put our president right back where he belongs. And this man's eyes, but he was writing in me, well, what is your name? Where do you live? And I told him everything. Whatever God said, say it, say it, say it. But this is the bushwhack of God. If nobody knows him, they don't realize when someone is anointed to carry his frequency, every word I spoke was piercing the soul of man. And he can't get it out of himself. And this is what happened. He'll have dreams about all the stuff God had to share. He'll think about it all the time. He'll hear the very words that I said will go round and round inside of him until at one point he will cry out to God, because his very presence has invaded him. That's the beauty of speaking things to people. You're bringing more than just life and hope to them, or even you think you're correcting somebody. When you release something from what God has said himself, you are actually partnering with God himself. And I can say this, I said to this man, no matter what man thinks they know, no matter what they think they got away with, I know the one who holds the air they breathe. And he's about to do something never expected and never thought it could happen, because they got away with nothing. But we who are trusting God and crying out to God, we will get every word we spoke that aligned with what God said. Justice is coming. It's written on his throne.
Right on.
And none of them can stop that from happening. So that was one of the best things that happened today.
That is so awesome. Babylon has fallen.
And it fell right on the head of this reporter.
Amazing. Amazing. I just love your commitment to obeying the Lord with no fear of man.
And no fear.
That's why I'm going to sit closer to her so I can let it rub off on me.
Did you know the anointing can rub off on you?
Oh, I'm really counting on it, because all I'm thinking right now is I'm so glad that reporter didn't find Johnny.
Oh no, he found me with pink hair, and he thought for sure this has got to be some crackpot of this person. You know what? Wearing the American flag. I got to see. You just get picked for different reasons.
Yeah,
he had no good reason. But I promise you, by the looks on his face, he never expected any of those words to be said by somebody, especially with pink hair, would tell you this is heaven culture right here.
He thought he was going to get political correctness out of political convention.
There was no political nothing. I said, when you hear truth, you know it. And whether you accept it or not, God is saying he will do, and no one can stop him from doing what he wants to do. So I'm excited.
Amen.
What a gift being and Kat are to our generation, right? This is just, for such a time as this, really, you're a mom and a dad to this generation of believers. Thank you for the hits that y'all take to do what you do, and you are a team. And
yes,
I know I speak for a lot of people that we love you so much, and we're so grateful for y'all.
Oh yeah, I could not do any of this without my husband, and he even handpicked my husband. I actually was married to somebody else. I just like to tell the truth, right? I mean, I just picked out anybody and thought they'll be fun to live with. It was like being in prison for 6 years. Do not run around and just pick up somebody. Girls, you hear me? Yeah. You wait for the right one from God to bring you, because he knows who you need, okay? You don't ever marry someone you can live with. You marry someone you can't live without. And this man behind me, we have been married for 43 years.
43
years. It's really been quite a road. But I can never say he's not the one. He is the one. God said, I found someone else. You will go break what you have with him. You will repent for marrying them. And I will bring you the one I have positioned for you, because you'll never be able to complete your destiny. I always wanted to do something great for God, and have known him since I was 4 years old. I actually saw Jesus Christ step inside of me the day I received him. Nobody could ever say he wasn't real to me. Being a seer, there's so much, your life is just totally different. And I could see this. The demons around that man, they were screaming like, no!
Oh, wow.
They wanted to get him out of there, but my angels would not let them. So just so you know what was going on in the unseen realm, a lot. The heavens were open. God was watching from above. He was celebrating that I was just letting him have the truth right. And then here's these demons who were with this person who didn't want him to write. When you write something down, it seals it. That's why he made the Ten Commandments, people. There's something about you writing it down.
Wow.
If you don't speak to people, write things in a journal. It seals those words in eternity. So here's this man writing the words of God on his little piece of paper, not even knowing he's being bushwhacked by God himself. But my angels really would not allow the demons to get near him. They zipped their mouth shut so they couldn't even speak to him, because this is what goes on. Sometimes people are influenced by them. They had no voice this day to speak to him, but God had every opportunity, because I was willing to say, but God wanted to say that man is probably going to be changed forever. Great thing. Yeah. Amen. He'll be changed forever, and those words will never leave him. He'll probably dream about God in heaven. I didn't mind mentioning anything, okay? It wasn't just what I talked about, the elections. I talked about God himself being the great creator, and how he loves everyone, and how what he allows, what he does not allow will not remain. And so all the evil of wickedness is not our new normal, people. Right. Our new normal will be so great, so filled with God. Signs and wonders, the manifested sons and daughters of God. Even young, you can be a manifested son or daughter of God. You can begin to hear him correctly. He can take you on encounters with him. This is his heart to know you. And so this man, probably according to Satan's rules, picked the worst person they possibly could to interview.
I love it.
I do too.
Well, all right. We're going to let you guys go. Thanks for joining us, and share this on your pages so that other people can be exposed to the truth.
Yes.
We want to circulate truth and good news, and yes, I love that you always bring truth and good news.
That's right. We need the truth. The truth will make you free.
All right. We'll see y'all the next time.
Bye.
That was great. That was the best.